Kids, wake up. It's 8 a.m. Wake up, wake up. Mom, please go away. It's only 8 a.m. and it's a holiday. Oh, today is October 2nd. But do you even know why today is a holiday?
Yeah, it's some Gandhi dude's birthday, right?
No, you fool. I think it's his death day.
How does it even matter? All that matters is that today is a holiday and I can sleep till 2 and play PUBG all day.
Yeah, and I'm off to Hakuna and probably then Hude Beach. It's going to be so much fun. Thank you, Father of our nation. It's so sad to see a man who fought for our nation, who struggled tirelessly for our nation, has been brought down to merely just a holiday. Fought for our nation, struggled for us. I thought he just made salt once, and no food is ever good without salt. That's why he became father of our nation. Oh, really now? So making salt makes you the father of our nation? That way, MDH spices should be king of the world. Lame. Then why was he so important? Let me take you through a little story about truth, non-violence, and religion, Gandhi's three strongest beliefs. On October 2nd, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born to a family in Porbandhan, Gujarat.
But why did the Britishers come to India? And who made them boss anyways?
That's an excellent question. The Britishers arrived in India in the early 1600s to establish trading posts under the East India Company. But by 1765, they were practically controlling most parts of India. Honestly though, that's very expected from Gujaratis. They find a way to trade anything to get their hands on some good dhoklas, don't they? But the Britishers treated Indians very badly. Farmers, workers, soldiers weren't even given their basic human rights. Something as simple as salt became a luxury to us Indians. That's when Gandhi stepped in and led the Dandi March from Sabarmati Ashram to show his rebellion against the British.
Is this why Gandhiji is so important to us?
Yes, but did you know Gandhiji also was a firm believer in God?
No, I did not know that. Who was the one who asserted that in him?
Do you know the song Raghupati Raghav Rajaram?
Yes, wasn't that the song that got popular because of him?
Exactly. Gandhiji's mother was the one who made him believe in God. Let me tell you a little story about him. When Gandhi was a young boy, his mother would often sleep without him and he would sleep in the dark.
Why, Mohan?
It's too dark in my room. And the candle keeps flickering off.
But why do you need light when it's dark already?
Ma, when I close my eyes, it's dark. But that darkness I can control. But when there is no light in my room, I get scared. And I need someone to be with me until I fall asleep. Can you please come with me, Ma?
But Mohan, why do you need someone when you know there is someone always there for you, no matter where?
Who, Ma?
Ram, Mohan. Hey, Ram. Sing with me. Hey, Ram. Hey, Ram.
And that's how Gandhi believed in God and built a strong relationship with his mother.
Oh, Mom, that is such a cute story. Was she also the reason he believed in the whole Satya thing?
Yes, but actually there was another incident that made Gandhi believe in Satya, or the truth. Gandhi wasn't always Mr. Goody Two-Shoes. He was young and popular. He would often go hang out with his friends to eat and, you know, like you call it, hang out, chill.
Hang out? Like in Hakuna? Is that okay?
Not quite. Gandhi would often go out with his friends and they would eat meat. But Gandhi's family values did not involve the consumption of meat or any other intoxicating substances. Yet he would once in a while take off a few bites. Gandhi felt bad about having to lie to his parents, and so he stopped. But he inculcated another bad habit. His friends would peer pressure him into smoking a few cigarettes. Gandhi would take a few puffs, but soon enough got addicted to him. It got to a point where Gandhi would sneak out of his house just to smoke some cigarettes. He ran out of money to pay for them.
But then he knew he couldn't ask his family for money. So, ek-ek karke, usne sare dukandaron se cigarette ka udhar dena shuru kar diya. He was terrified. The last thing he wanted was for his parents to find out about this bad habit. He went home, tried to think of a way that he could repay his loans. He saw a box on the floor. He opened it and found his brother's gold amulet inside. He took it and decided to exchange it for some money. He went to a goldsmith who gave him some money and he happily paid off all his loans. But then he went home. He was sad. He was ashamed of what he had just done. He decided to write his father a letter confessing to everything he had just done.
What is this, Mohandas?
Just read it, Baba.
Lying, stealing, smoking. Is this true?
Yes, Baba, I'm sorry. I did not mean to start smoking cigarettes.
Mohandas, listen to me. Smoking cigarettes is wrong. And I understand that you made a mistake. But lying, stealing, that's not who I made you to be. Promise me, Mohandas, you'll never lie.
I promise, Baba, I'll never lie to you again.
Mohandas, remember my son. सत्य की हमेशा विजय होती है.
And that's why Gandhi always was truthful. No matter how hard the situation was, he always stood by that moral.
Mom, that's such a cute story. I wish you were half as forgiving though.
Excuse me.
But Mom, wasn't Gandhi a lawyer or something?
Yes, as a matter of fact, Gandhi grew up to be a lawyer from London. He was called far and wide to fight cases and bring justice to Indians.
Yes, I heard that he traveled to South Africa to fight for Indians.
Yes.
Mom, she didn't know that. She Googled it right now, trying to impress you.
Oh, whatever. That's not true. But weren't conditions in India really terrible at the time?
Conditions in India were going from bad to worse. Indians, like I said, were not even getting their basic human rights. They were all treated terribly, and the Britishers would throw dust in our eyes, making us believe that all of this was towards a stronger and better India. But for them, we were just dogs, brown, slaves. Gandhi wasn't treated any differently. The year was 1893. June 7th, to be exact, Gandhi was called to South Africa to fight a case for Indians who were not treated right. He was given a first-class ticket from Durban to Pretoria so that he could be there as soon as possible.
Saab ji, mera ek sawal hai.
Haan ji, zarur poochhe.
Saab ji, aap is compartment mein kaise baithe hain?
Arre, mere paas first-class ka ticket hai, bhai. Isliye main yahan baitha hu.
Lekin saab ji, aap...
Him? Right here? How dare you let him sit with us?
Hey, who let you come here?
I'm sorry, sir. Do we have a problem?
Yes, show me your ticket.
Okay, give me a minute. Here you go. Sir, excuse me. That's my ticket, sir. You cannot do that.
Brown people and dogs are not allowed here. Get out.
Sir, that's preposterous. I have a ticket to this seat and that is where I will sit.
Well, you don't have a ticket to prove it.
Sir, I'm traveling from India to South Africa for my work.
Work? What work?
Madam, I'm a lawyer. I practice law.
But as for my information, there are no colored attorneys in South Africa. Get him out of here.
Sir, I'm telling you one last time, get out from here.
I'm sorry, sir. I refuse to leave.
Please get out.
Sir, excuse me.
A man, just the presence of a brown man on the first class compartment was of absolute disgust to the Britishers. He was thrown off the train and was lying on the railway station. Shivering through the cold winter night, Gandhi brooded over what had just happened. Gandhi wasn't one who was conspicuous towards assertiveness. On the other hand, he was shy and retiring. But something happened to him in that wind-swept waiting room as he brooded over the insult inflicted upon him. The iron had entered his soul, and from that moment onwards, there was no turning back. Gandhi decided to fight for the justice of his brothers and sisters. He loved our country, and he was proud of our rich and varied heritage.
No one did more than Gandhi to improve the conditions of Indians. If his dreams fell short of the reality, it was not because his dreams were flawed, but because the human race, who he loved so much, could not live up to the expectations set by him.
Gandhi's teachings live in his legacy even now. He continues to inspire us and nations all over the world.
लाठी पकड़े चलते थे वो शान से सालिम कांपे थर 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 सुनकर उनका नाम रे पद था उनका छोटा सा और सरपट उनकी चाल रे दुबले से पतले से थे वो चलते सीना तान गए
रघुपति राम।